Here's our notes. Here's our notes for Friday, 4th of Feb to Friday. Yep, so we'll do more budgets, investments, systems of linear equations. So here's the table in your notes. Say you put away $1,000, like just $1,000 at the beginning of a year. You don't keep adding $1,000 every year. You just put away $1,000 once. At the end of 1 year, it'll be worth $1,100. But now they pay interest on it. So in the second year, you get interest on your original plus the interest that they gave you the previous year. So you'll notice that it actually grows exponentially. We did exponents in unit A. Notice how the N, the number of years, is in the exponent. It's an exponential equation. Here's the formula. Most people love this formula. So say you borrow $1,000 at 10%, and you're going to pay it back after 3 years. So you plug into the formula. Your uncle reminds you every year at Christmas, oh, by the way, you owe me that money still, and a bit of interest. So after 3 years, you pay him back $1,331. So your uncle makes $331. But that's fine. I mean, he could have done something with it instead of loaning it to you. Now what happens if you take $1,000 and you put it away for 20 years? Or if you borrow it for 20 years? Yep, it becomes $6,700. Wow. How about if you take $5,000 and put it away for 4 years? It becomes $7,320. Yeah, that's if they calculate the interest once per year, annually. But if they calculate the interest four times a year, it becomes $7,422. So the more often they calculate it, the more often it's compounded, the slightly better money you get. But it's not like four times better or 365 times better. Here's a calculation for daily savings, daily interest savings. So remember that quarterly you got 7422, annually you got 7320, you only get 7458. It really doesn't make a heck of a big difference whether you're monthly or daily. So there's what the words mean. Semi-annual means two per year. Try typing that equation into a graphing calculator. You'll see your money growing, just like we did in unit A. Oh, here's that little rule of 72. I won't quiz you on this or anything, but there is a little mental math trick you can do to calculate how long it takes for your money to double. So, for example, if you invest any amount of money at 6%, it will take 12 years to double, because 6 times 12 is 72. If you invested at 9%, well, 9 times 8 is 72. So whatever amount of money you put away at 9%, it will double after 8 years. And it's not exact, but it's awfully darn close, all right, for interest rates between 1 to 12% type thing. So it's good for a certain domain of interest rates. Every real estate agent knows this rule, and banker. Oh, I love these. 2 years ago, a man was 6 times as old as his son, and 18 years would be twice as old as his son. What are their ages now? Oh, man, that's just wicked. I'll just, you just got to set up the equations, right? Just look at that. Equation one from the first sentence, equation two from the second sentence. As we said, D is the dad's age now. So D minus 2 would be the dad's age 2 years ago. And if S was the son's age now, then S minus 2 would have been the son's age 2 years ago. So you've got to sort of write these things down. They're not that tough. You just got to practice. I've got a hockey sock full of these word problems. So anyway, the dad must be 32 today, and the son is 7 today. And if you check that answer by sticking it back into the sentences, you'll find that's true. That means the dad was 30 when the kid was 6, so he was 5 times older. And it also means when the dad is 50 in 18 years, the kid will be 25. So it does work. 32 for the dad and 7 for the son does work. Here's another one of those paddling problems. We'll just accelerate this. Yeah, I guess my words didn't come out there. Anyway, if he goes with the river 9 miles in 2 hours, most people call 9 miles in 2 hours 4.5 miles an hour. And when he goes against the current, upstream, he's going 9 miles in 6 hours. And most people say 9 miles in 6 hours is 1.5 miles per hour. Kind of advanced physics there, right? Miles per 1 hour. That's what you call miles per hour. Anyway, doing the math, you find out the current's 1.5 knots, or miles an hour, rather. And the rower must be, where is he here? Here comes the rower. 3. Survey says 3. And you should check your answer, and it does work. All right. Just about done here. And I think we only get time to do number 3, and then the day ended. Let's do number 3 here. That one about two numbers added twice the second, the result is 21. So as usual, you should always, always give your unknowns names. Hard to talk about something if it doesn't have a name. So A is the first number, B is the second number. First sentence says that A plus 2 B's is 21, B plus 2 A's is 18. What do you want to do? Eliminate something? Sure. Let's subtract two bunches of equation 2 from equation 1. So we'll take equation 1 and subtract double equation 2. Look at that. That's going to eliminate the B's. So it ends up A is 5, then we're going to plug that back in. Let me slow her down a bit here. And I think that pretty much concludes the week's worth of notes. Well, hope this helped a bit.